person who... 57.
A rare plane, only two of them in the world, and we have one. The other one's in Italy.
Oh, she said the tour's in the front?
Over there, I think. Kind of engine.
Look at that skull right there.
Uh-huh. I hear somebody talking over.
Me too.
Special investigations, watches over the Air Force and the Department of Defense, protecting us.
Thank you. Bill. Bill. Hey. So.
seeing a picture of this thing. Nope. He is trying to hook up and pull back on board. You can see, you know, even back in the 50s, how tight they wound up. Well, here's what it really refuels, KC-97. This was a variant of the B-29 again. We put on extra double bubble fuselage here. So it's not only a cargo carrier, but this thing could carry a whole lot of fuel. And it's the first one in the world, which you can't see from here, but in the back, the flying boom to go down and extend a tube and give fuel to the aircraft behind it. The problem was you're starting to refuel jets. And these things initially had a top speed of about 200.
The other thing they need to be able to do aircraft was the test of the new
that made the explosion separate from the bomb. And the Atomic Energy Commission had charge of the nuclear capsule.
Deliverable
slowly,
hydrogen bomb.
Well, you get the hell away from it. And get out of the blast radius. So you want it to have quite a long time before it hits the surface so you can get away. This thing was potentially 10 million tons of TNT. Dropped on Japan was the one up front near the boat's car.
Service.
Mark 6 nuclear bomb.
And
Mark 17, there may be a nuclear bomb.
What?
Mark 17, that's the hydrogen bomb. That's huge. Mark 39, thermonuclear weapon.
It's manual. I've worked on that site.
This again, concept was to apply the higher fashion.
Delta bombers.
Down here on the bottom, it's kind of hard to see, there's two little nipples. And once a quarter, we go down and go through life support and go through the vent. We can fill it. Matic, about 5 to 50. And then you go over the swimming pool and
the 2 Delta Dagger. SR-71 Blackbird. stealth bomber.
Shoot. Fighter.
Transformer toys, and you can do it in a sense. But we use it for search and rescue now, and for special operations missions of the Air Force.
How did you guys acquire this?
That was one of the test versions, and they used it for test flying for a number of years, and finally decided they done everything with it they were going to do. And 3 years ago, in February, in a really damn cold day, landed it out here on the runway, and bird. Oh, I feel for the poor guy that was on the ground that day. Well, here's the A-10 tank killer. If we ever had World War III happen in Europe, take out all the Soviet tanks on the coast. We know that that great big cannons, VA, if they turn it on the air,
Osprey.
Firing slugs like the thick rough grass creams in there in case. Little rain. It's dead stuff that we have access to. Yep. So let's talk about the mark.
They had to put a uranium in here.
Yeah. These things could get really, really shot up and still fly. Or tank killers.
Looks like they are missiles too.
Yeah. And they have this huge Gatling gun on the front. Spins and shoots.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like.
Yeah. It's a lot of weaponry. Holy cow. Look at all that.
Yeah.
Those are big bullets.
Show you the B-2, which is actually, that B-2 we have was the one that they used for testing to destroy the testing aircraft.
Southeast Asia hangar that is hanging up. You can walk over to where the curtain lobby thing is, an F-4, and there's a big C-121 radar plane sitting in there.
Say again, what's that?
It is in Korea, Southeast Asia. So.
Get back to Chile.
111A. Cruise missile. Secret cow. Roosevelt's plane. Truman's aircraft. He named it the Independence. Eisenhower, please. Here's the Aero Commander. Thank you. The B. Johnson. Kennedy's plane. Crap.
What?